Welcome to the University of Huddersfield, Dr. Hayaatun Sillem. How does it feel to be here on campus with us today?
I'm so excited to be here on campus. I came here last in 2019 and I can't believe how much has changed. As ever, it's such an exciting place to be, and from an engineering perspective, really, it just is such an inspiring set of activities and people that I meet every single time I come.
You've been named as one of the inspiring 50 women in tech and one of the most influential women in engineering. You will definitely inspire our students here at Huddersfield, but we'd like to know who's inspired you in your life and career.
I've been really lucky to work with some amazing people, but I think that there are two groups of people that have made the most difference to my life. One person who's really inspired me is my dad. So he was the first person in his family to go to secondary school. He was brought up in apartheid South Africa. And he's just brought me up with his amazing value system and kind of encouraged me to appreciate everything that life throws my way and to always take responsibility, you know, reflect on myself, what can I do differently? Not just look at all the things that are wrong in the world around me, but think, what are you going to do about making that better? And then the other group of people who've been so influential have been my peer mentors and coaches, people at similar career stages who have been just amazing cheerleaders and challengers sometimes, you know, people who put me straight when I'm just having a whinge about life. And I think that that peer coaching has really, really helped me make progress in my career. So those two groups of people have been amazingly important and inspiring.
As an influential figure, you've been able to use your position to support diversity and inclusion, including working alongside Lewis Hamilton to encourage black representation in UK motorsport. How do you feel how much progress has been made in increasing diversity in the industry, and what would you like to see in the future?
We have made progress in terms of improving diversity and inclusion in engineering, but unfortunately the pace of change is still not acceptable. So we still have a profession in the UK that is made up of 16.5% women, which is still incredibly low when you look at international comparisons and other professions. And there are lots of other aspects of our diversity deficit when you look at different characteristics that really trouble me. And it matters because engineers shape the world we live in a really profound way. And it's incredibly important that we can be reflective of the society that we serve. What I can definitely see as a positive is that there is no serious leader in engineering now who does not consider it a personal and professional priority to improve diversity and inclusion. It's now understood to be core to business. It's necessary, it's not just a nice to have.
What barriers do you feel you have had to overcome to progress throughout your career?
One barrier that I've probably experienced quite a bit is assumptions. As somebody who comes from lots of underrepresented groups within my kind of peer community, I don't think that I'm the first person that people would picture if they thought of the CEO of the Royal Academy of Engineering. And it was quite funny when I took up this role. I learned quite quickly that some people are not very good at rearranging their facial expressions to hide their surprise. So I've had a lot of people very taken aback to find that I'm doing roles that I'm doing. And sometimes that can get a bit wearing. But you know what? In the long term, I think, well, once they've had this experience, then hopefully they'll think twice about what a leader in engineering looks like. And so in a practical way, just by showing up and hopefully doing a good job, I'm helping to change perceptions.
Many of our students here balance their studies with being a parent, for example. How do you deal with those challenges of achieving that work-life balance whilst juggling your career and your family commitments?
Yes, yeah, so I'm a working mum. I've got two fantastic children now, 13 and 11. And I've worked since they were really young. And I've also got parents who I try and help to look after as well. And it makes life very full, very busy, but I feel as if I'm incredibly lucky to be able to pursue a fulfilling career as well as being a hands-on present parent. And for me, the most important factor has been to make conscious choices, to really think about what matters to me. There's no right answer to how much you should or shouldn't work. There's no formula that will work for everybody. But for me, no one in my family thinks I'd be a better parent if I stayed at home all the time. I'm much nicer when I have a fulfilling job. And I don't feel ashamed about that. I'm not someone who's guilt-stricken. So I think it comes down to thinking really hard about what you'll feel when you look back 10 or 20 years hence about the decisions you made, and doing your best within the bounds of what's possible to make decisions that you'll feel comfortable with.
And finally, what advice would you give to our graduates, particularly those who are thinking of going into the fields of engineering, science and technology?
Well, the first thing I'd say, you've chosen an amazing career path. These are careers that literally will shape our future. And I think one of my most important learnings personally has been that it's just incredibly important to embrace whatever makes you you. We all feel different, we all have our struggles. There'll be good days, there'll be bad days. But learn to know yourself and to love yourself and to live in a way that's consistent with your values and who you are. And if you do that, everything else will flow.